Welcome to highlights of the third World Series Cup match in the 1990-91 season. And this is the game between Australia and New Zealand at the Adelaide Oval. Yesterday, a great win for New Zealand over England against all the odds. They only made 199 and then bowled out the Englishman. Today, in excellent conditions at the Adelaide Oval, it is Alan Border's side against Martin Crowe's team. Now, this is the situation in the World Series Cup in the points table. That's the way it looks with only a few matches played so far. Australia 2 points, New Zealand 2 from 2 games, and the Englishman nothing at all following on that debacle up in Brisbane in the first test where the game was over in 3 days. The two teams for today's match, the toss was won by Martin Crowe and he decided to bat, exchanged the teams with Alan Border. That's the way it looked. The Australians Marsh, Boone, Jones, Border himself, the two Waughs, O'Donnell, Taylor, Healy, Rackerman, Alderman and Reid. And New Zealand have Martin Crowe as skipper. Andrew Jones and John Wright will be hoping for a faster start than they managed yesterday against England. Then Rutherford, who played so well yesterday for 50 from 53 balls. Latham had a good match. Ian Smith, Harris, Petrie, Pringle, Morrison, Watson and Bradburn. We join play now in excellent conditions. Alderman is the bowler. It's the fifth over. He's coming into bowl to Jones and 8 runs are on the board without loss.
Big shouts. It's got him. Alderman strikes again. Andrew Jones hitting across the line. Border changed the field placings. Jones was looking to the onside. And he paid the penalty.
Well, I don't like to see too many LBWs given when the batsman's that far forward, that there has to be enough doubt there. New Zealand 1 for 8 after 5 overs.
Captain Martin Crowe making his way to the crease. Ball of Jones's wicket for 4. New Zealand 1 for 8.
I thought with the naked eye that Andrew Jones was well forward when playing that shot to Terry Alderman. Makes it dangerous to give LBWs when a batsman's a long way forward. He's got the back foot out of the crease, so that suggests that he's a fair way forward. Ooh, he's a long way forward. I wouldn't be very happy if I was the batsman.
This is Rackerman. That'll be difficult to cut off. A glorious stroke. First one where Carl Rackerman is straight in length.
Nice amount of bounce. Good even bounce on this wicket. It gives the batsman every chance in the world to confidently play the horizontal bat shots, and the result was very, very positive.
1 for 27, here's Alderman. Healy's in the game again. He'll make the throw, but can he save 3? Yes, he does, and that's good cricket again.
As you said, Healy already responsible for perhaps saving 2 runs there. His contribution with the bat no doubt will be invaluable. Really, the wicketkeeper he's the focus for the fielding team. He's the one responsible for morale. He's the one to G them all up. You know, to have direct contact. Sure, the captain places the field, but the energy within the fielding team, it's all about the wicketkeeper. If he's slack and lethargic, then it generally is contagious.
Beautifully done. Healy again, he's been in the game right from the start today, and that was brilliant.
Well, at 36 years of age, stiffness overnight, it looked like a man who wasn't as loose as perhaps he ought to have been. He tried the professional nudge of the pad down the leg side here. Watch this. He knows he's got a deflection, but really, didn't look like regaining his ground. So there we are. The former New Zealand captain is out. Look at that. That is a splendid piece of work by Healy. Picking up. I don't think he even got the glove off. So Wright is now out. 16 runs against his name. And New Zealand at 2 for 38.
This is the man who played so well yesterday at just the right moment for New Zealand. 50 and 53 balls. Ken Rutherford.
really Martin Crowe is the key for New Zealand. He's the star batsman. He's on 12. He's facing Steve Waugh, who's a very handy one-day bowler. Well driven and well fielded, my word, he's a good first. Oh, that would have been a sensational run out by Mark Waugh. He backhanded that on the ground and just missed. Oh, what a fieldman. He's got a great pair of hands. He's happy, and so he should be. That's really putting pressure on the batsman.
Well, that's right. That's absolutely fabulous feeling. Great stop with his left hand, his weak hand, and then backflipped it. And my goodness, he did deserve to run the batsman out. That really is quick thinking. Clever, clever cricket.
Got him? No, he hasn't. Well, he drove on the up. Waugh's normally a very safe fieldsman. He was there. And that's a let-off for Ken Rutherford.
Yes, I think it was a mistimed drive. The ball came back actually slower than the bowler expected. Yes, it sort of loops back, lollipops slowly, never quite gets to it, Steve Waugh.
Rutherford on 5, Crowe 14. Nice off drive, and it beats Carl Rackerman. Should almost run 4 here if they start sprinting. That's the second boundary of the morning, all run 4. It's the situation for New Zealand. Far too many overs with just one run, 2 maidens, and just the one good over with 7 runs. But really, they need to lift their run rate to give Australia a reasonable total to chase. Full points to the Australian bowlers. They've been tidy. There's this time. That breaks the shackles. Marsh is out there. Doesn't stop it. That's unusual. A rare error from an Australian fieldsman. It's 2 for 62.
31 to Martin Crowe, 22 Ken Rutherford. Now look at the difference here. Simon O'Donnell quickly onto it and very nearly got the run out. And that really is the difference between these two sides. It's a lovely piece of work from O'Donnell. Gathered it in and low, throwing slightly off balance. He was only a matter of a few millimetres from pulling off a sensational run out. Carl Rackerman being called back into the attack. He takes over from Steve Waugh. Waugh with 7 overs for 26.
It's another good shot this time. It looks like it beat the fieldsman. O'Donnell in chase. Put down the glasses. That is a good shot. That's the end of the Rackerman over. 2 for 109.
Now, Peter Taylor, we were talking about a moment ago. Alan Border is bringing him into the attack from the cathedral end.
Well, I'm not too sure whether that was on the full. From the look of Taylor, it may have been. This is the way the batsman would have seen it. Stump vision. And look at that. It was a sitter, really. Hit very firmly. Just didn't quite hit soft hands. Martin Crowe hitting the ball back down the wicket at off-spinner Taylor. Goes off the ground and big Bruce Reid comes in. He'll take up his position at mid-on. Oh, that's a good delivery. There's a big shout. Carl Rackerman goes up. Only in despair. So close.
Well, the umpire's not moved. That was a nice quick delivery by Carl Rackerman. Really bent his back and it nipped through between bat and pad. Probably clipped the top of the thigh. Certain Martin Crowe's not moving. Yes, to me that didn't look as if he touched it. Went between bat and pad. Sharp delivery.
Change of bowling after that drop catch and, of course, Peter Taylor going off the field. Mark Waugh. Another good shot, making room. In fact, Martin Crowe's feet are moving much better now. Middled that shot, placed it well, and a fine half century to the New Zealand captain.
Yes, he hits the ball square on the offside very well because he looks to play it at cover point, but the face of the bat opens. He almost slices it away square on the offside.
This is in the air and he's already on his way. A half century, then an indifferent shot. Going back to repeat the shot past cover point. Hit it high on the blade. And the catch just balloons out to mid-off. Dean Jones takes the catch. And that's the end of a very, very good partnership.
Well, Martin Crowe getting into the shot too quickly, trying to hit it over the top of mid-off, mistimes it, and a simple, easy catch that Jones could have caught in his pocket. 3 for 122.
New batsman at the crease is Rodney Latham. Carl Rackerman straight through the gate between bat and pad. Over he goes. Rutherford out. 40 runs. There for 70 balls. The big fella persisted. Initially, it was the shorter, bouncy delivery. Up in the block hole, the trademark. And out goes Rutherford. Clean bowled, Carl Rackerman.
Well, Rutherford never got his feet moved. It's a little bit of a shuffle there. There's no feet look. The feet almost stuck in cement. Bit of extra pace and bounce, not allowing him to get forward by Carl Rackerman. New Zealand 4 for 123.
New batsman at the crease, New Zealand wicketkeeper Ian Smith, very experienced player, top score of 62, likes to hit the ball. That's a big one, a lot of bottom hand in that shot. And that's a favourite shot. Ian Smith, New Zealand keeper. It's the sort of shot we come to expect of him. He comes to the crease often in this situation where he's got to just have a look at one or two and then go over the short men inside the 30-metre circle. And that one is absolutely no problems. 4 runs. Look at this one. Wow, that's a play and a contact. A thickish edge goes very fine to the keeper, Healy, who accepts in the finish the easiest of catches. So Rackerman, two very good wickets in the space of a couple of overs, sending back Rutherford and now Smith. You play dangerously, you say goodbye dangerously.
Well, just a full-blooded swipe there by Smith and he nicked it to the keeper. They're now in big trouble, 5 for 131.
New batsman to the crease is Chris Harris, left-handed all-rounder.
And Ian Smith decided to take him on with the extra bounce and pace. He made contact, went straight through to Healy, a regulation catch. He was out for 6 off 6 deliveries faced. And Rackman picks up his second wicket. Maybe Smith could have waited for Mark Waugh. Maybe a bit easier to hit than Rackman. Rackman's a very difficult customer. Waldman 1 for 16 off 8. Rackerman 2 for 37. Donald Nowick for 23. Steve Waugh Nowick for 26. Mark Waugh. It's wide and it's going way down. But we find that Mark Waugh hit the bails. He's followed through. Steve Waugh extended his hand. 4 wides.
It was even worse for New Zealand when Chris Harris was out, also caught by Ian Healy. Mark Waugh was the bowler this time. We join play now in the 43rd over. Waugh is bowling again and Petrie is taking strike.
Oh, have the ability to have success with both bat and ball, and it gives the batting so much depth. Healy batting at 9, so New Zealand will be aware of that. They'll have to bowl very well to stay in this match, bordering complete control. Taking his time with his field placements. Good shot. Comes up for 154-6.
6 overs to be bowled, and they'll be bowled, I would think, by Simon O'Donnell now, operating at the cathedral end. And I reckon it'll be Steve Waugh to finish out at the other end. And there's the first boundary since the 38th over, hit by Richard Petrie.
We need quite a few more of those. Petrie deciding this one's good enough to go. Vacant area straight. We've got to be a little careful. He has got protection down there at mid-off. He's going to make sure that he hits to the left-hand side of the umpire and high.
Oh, well bowled. Steve Waugh jams the Yorker through Petrie. So Petrie is gone for 21. And the seventh New Zealand wicket is down.
Experience Waugh, almost 100 one-day internationals. Persistence there. Petrie, not really a good offside player, playing around that one. Good length from Waugh. Pretty happy to see this, the end of the all-rounder. 21 off 18 was a good effort. 48 overs, 7 for 185.
Chris Pringle, who has played 8 one-day internationals.
A little more.
He's a big bloke. Not sure how he uses the willow. The figures don't tell you a lot there. He comes in to replace Richard Petrie, who was out for 21.
The benefits of bowling at the stumps. Wait for the batsman to miss, get results.
And a rare boundary for New Zealand.
That shot, pure muscle. Not too much aesthetics in this shot. Pretty strong forearms. Really was, in the finish, a bit of a slog.
Steve Waugh bowls the last over. And Carl Rackerman has just been moved back to long off. Dean Jones has come up into the circle at fine leg.
Apparently got a huge appetite too, not just for the game of cricket. He likes his food. Just a grown boy at 22 years of age. Showed terrific ability with the ball.
Oh, and that's going to hurt a bit. Oh, that's not a good idea. Johnny Gleeson used to favour the method of stopping the ball with the boot, but at least he used to do it with the bottom of his boot. Steve Waugh has done it with the side of the boot, I reckon. Right on the instep, that's got a smart. That's a six. That is well hit.
Third time lucky. Two runs. And one pretty close to the bottom of the bat. This one has hit dead center in the middle. Watch this one go. A lot of bottom hand there. That was never intended to go along the carpet. The overwhelming urge to hit one over the fence has taken this fellow.
David Boone at deep cover. 200 has been brought up for New Zealand in fine style with that six. And the last 50 was the fastest one, coming off 43 deliveries. Australians all back on the circle, the four of them in the infield. And a good save by David Boone because he got a rough bounce. The ball took a rough kick on him there. And it looked like a baseballer grabbing it one hand. He didn't have the glove, but that's a good piece of work. And that really signifies the end of a tremendous performance by the Australians. Their fielding has been terrific, and Booney's really enjoyed that one and just showing his teammates the rough bounce that he got. The 209 is the target for Australia at a run rate of 4.18 per over. And some good bowling and brilliant fielding from the Australians really restricting New Zealand to a very gettable total. We'll be back here at the Adelaide Oval to see how gettable Australia make it.
Well, that was very much better than it might have been for New Zealand. They recovered well towards the end. When you think yesterday they won a match making only 199, they must be in with a decent chance against Australia now. This is the card of the New Zealand innings. They looked at one stage as though they might be restricted to about 185. Got up to 7 for 208 in their full 50 overs. Right out for 16, Jones 4. And the top scorers, Martin Crowe 50. It took him 92 balls though. Rutherford 40 from 70. Latham, another good performance from him. He struck the ball really well, 36 from 48 balls. And the bowling figures for Australia, it was an outstanding effort, I thought, from the Australians today on a ground with a fast outfield, a really good pitch. Alderman 1 for 25 in 10 overs. That is very good. And, Rackerman 2 for 38 from a full 10. O'Donnell none for 45. Steve Waugh 1 for 49. And Mark Waugh came in when Peter Taylor was injured and did a terrific job. 5 overs, no maiden. 2 for 25. So the Australians, well, they don't have all that many runs to chase, but New Zealand did it yesterday. It should be a very, very good match.
A chance, if he hits it. Oh, good chance of overthrows as well. They'll pick up one. Oh, there was a chance there. Hesitation between the batsmen.
Very often we see some terrific running. Rarely do we see the mix-up. Marsh always seemed to be in control then, but there was some doubt in the mind of David Boone. He had to quickly scamper back. Place some pressure on that wobbly knee joint that these days has been strengthened by lots of exercise.
Pringle continues. Boone cuts high and wide for four. That's the way to play in one-day cricket in the first 15 overs. He didn't try to keep it on the ground. He went over the top and it crashes into the fence at backward point.
Beautiful shot straight out of the David Boone scrapbook. Have a look at this. He goes back and across. Too short. Bang. Every ounce of strength that he could summons up. That one really did race away to the boundary. Look at that. Watch the ball right onto the face of the bat.
Glorious shot. That's Jeff Marsh at his best. He's played some glorious cover drives this year. Showing he's seen the ball early. His footwork is good, and that was a superb stroke.
It probably will be the turning point. It's been pretty much defence so far from the Australians. He's waited for the opportunity. Loves the off drive. Even able to cope with the outswing. Totally in control of that shot. Look at this nice footwork. See the head stayed down, and he knew from the moment he struck that ball that it was going to be a boundary.
We'll toss, that's four more. I'll play Jeff Marsh. He can't afford to bowl into the slot to top order batsman.
Very good offside player, loves to drive. He's just changed the length of that by batting outside the crease. Made that into a full toss. Again, very good in his judgment of where to place the ball.
Dropped at first slip. A little slow to move there. Reacting late and then diving away to his right. Ken Rutherford.
Well, a nice wide ball to drive at on the up. Went late, one-handed. Little bit of luck that David Boone needs to get a score. Just pushing through it a little bit, on the move with his feet.
At the scoreboard end, it's to be Willie Watson. Boundary to David Boone. Takes him into double figures and Australia along to 34. Doesn't miss this time.
Well, Jeffrey Marsh playing a gorgeous cover drive there, letting the ball come on to him, just easing it away, not trying to hit it too hard, just timing it quite beautifully.
Three boundaries to Jeffrey Marsh in his 19. Willie Watson will continue from the scoreboard end. Second boundary from Willie Watson, taken by David Byrne, both of them in that area.
Yes, again a poor ball from Willie Watson, strained down the leg side to David Byrne. He just picks it up quite beautifully. There it is, he's a powerful man in that area. Anybody who's seen him back knows he's a great cutter of the ball and he picks everything up off his legs. New Zealand can't exert any pressure if they give away four balls.
Danny Morrison, who bowled two overs in his first spell from the river end, is back on now. A shot from David Byrne. They'll get four one way or the other. They'll either go or they'll run them. That brings up the 50 for Australia. Four all run. The last four he'll hit with that one. Unless he wants to give him a bit of a chance and play with a short one.
Well done, David Byrne. Struck a four with half a bat. He must be a powerful lad. Well, full-blooded pull shot. The ball disappears and so does the bat, high into the air. He still managed to get enough wood on the ball, made the boundary quite comfortably before the bat broke in half. Look, he hits it right in the middle, the bat shoots away.
I tell you what, like all true batsmen, he was more interested in where the ball was going. He's had a bit of a quick look at the blade flying through the air, but then he realised that the ball was going in the air and his eyes quickly went to the ball just to make sure that he wasn't going to get caught. A true batsman. Beautiful shot. Byrne now starting to race away from Geoffrey Marsh.
It's these sort of bad balls, a rank half volley here that David Byrne puts away that's killing New Zealand. Four balls, too many four balls. Puts it away quite neatly. And the thing is, there are no slips now, so that when they ball a good ball, they don't get the reward of a catch at slip. And they're not managing to keep the run rate down.
There's the first one down. Quick look back from David Byrne to the square leg umpire to see whether that was going to be above shoulder height and be called a no ball. But it was a fruitless look.
Well, Byrne has had success with half a bat and with a full bat in that area. But on this occasion, too close to the splice. The bat didn't break in half, but the innings is over for David Byrne. Caught it square leg. A good knock there, 33 runs. Australia have lost their first wicket for 64.
Very good crowd in today and a great welcome for Dean Jones as he comes out to take David Boone's place.
Martin Crowe just bowling gentle medium paces with the keeper standing up.
Oh, and they go for leg side. Stumping maybe, and it's byes or leg byes. The racehorse Jones sprinting through the 20 metres. Look at him go. Back he comes. Excellent running. Four wides.
There wasn't much that Ian Smith could do about that one. That was headed for the hills. Not quite, actually, here in Adelaide. It was headed for Mondafour Hill from the time it left Martin Crowe's hand.
That's a better shot. That's four.
And that was exactly the same ball that was called a wide. Just because the batsman hits it, it's not a wide. Ridiculous. One for 107.
Marsh 40 off 69. Hatchery continues. Well struck. Glorious cover drive. He's played four of those today.
Really leaves it late to bring his hands through Geoffrey Marsh. That's why he prefers the square drive rather than the normal cover drive.
Chris Harris coming back into the attack. Out, straight to right at cover point. And Harris picks up Geoff Marsh for 45.
Yes, he's having a little bit of hamstring trouble, I think, Chris Harris, but that'll make it feel better. A wicket. A leg cutter, just rolling the fingers across it. And a simple catch for John Wright. So the second Australian wicket is down with the score 115.
Alan Border getting the Border chant here at the Adelaide Oval. Popular Australian captain, rightly so. He's taking Australia to the top of the tree. Some magnificent individual performances. Fine captaincy in recent years, and now he's captain of a very good side. Balls off the mark nicely through mid-wicket, short boundary. Two for 119.
It's going to be a good catch if he gets it. Great attempt. Latham, who batted so well for New Zealand, almost pulled it off for Chris Harris.
Well, that was a great effort. Alan Border tries to go over the top. It slices off the face. It goes very, very high. And Latham makes a really valiant attempt. Good effort.
A shot. Well timed. No trouble getting over the three men in the infield on the offside. After 41 overs, Australia 2 for 171. Australia strolling to victory here at the Adelaide Oval. Alan Border decides to pick up the pace a little, just giving himself a bit of room there against Danny Morrison.
This is the type of batting that they've come to see. Their Australian captain unleashing a series of shots. Watched a couple of drives over the top, but that one all the way along the turf. Picked the gap, opened up the shoulders. Good timing. Looks to be a good blade that he's got. Plenty of colour on or around the middle.
Finding the gap on either side of the wicket there. First ball, the gap was picked on the offside. On that occasion, it was the onside.
And on consecutive occasions, finding the middle too. He struck that one beautifully, giving himself plenty of room in case he needed to hit the ball through the offside again, but the ball was so far down the leg side, the easiest way home was straight through mid-wicket. That total of 209 becoming very, very close.
McBorder's going for the 6-4s in this over. He's got intent in the back loop.
Danny Morrison slightly confused with the footwork. He's definitely overpitched two of the three. The first one, Border was good enough to turn into a half volley. But that was stump high. When it reached the popping crease and Border able to dictate the terms, crash it past point.
In the air to mid-off. And Dean Jones doesn't even worry about running. He just walks from the field. A simple catch there for Ken Rutherford at mid-off. So I would say that must have come off the back of the bat as Dean Jones attempted to loft it away on the onside. Third wicket is down.
So Dean Jones looking for the vacant area at mid-wicket. Not the best delivery in the world to pick up a wicket, but when they're that tough to get, Willie Watson would be quite happy to pick up the wicket of Dean Jones. 38. Australia 3 for 187.
Border is on 44. Mark Waugh having just come to the crease. Chris Pringle now is going to replace Danny Morrison at the river end. Pringle will be bowling to Alan Border. Border giving himself a bit of room once again. He's had some success in the last over from this end. Danny Morrison, who gave him a hard time. And he's starting on Pringle now.
He really does enjoy the flat bat swat. Stood there, very firm wrists. Somewhere around mid-wicket to backward, a square leg was the target.
City of Adelaide bathed in sunshine as Australia cruised to victory at the Adelaide Oval. In the commentary position now, Phil Laurie and Richie Benno.
Thank you, Ian. And Border drives beautifully, brings up his 50 through the cover region. One of his best shots, his cover drive, to the pitch of the ball, raced away for four. He's been the star here today. He's lifted the run rate. And the Australian captain, who got a magnificent ovation when he strode to the wicket, has not let this large crowd down. He's 53. Mark Waugh yet to score. 3 for 197. Around the wicket comes Pringle to Border. Got him. Drags it back onto the stumps. A different angle, trying to smash it square of the wicket. Pringle finds an edge and bowls Border.
Alan Border played very well. He had a wonderful reception when he walked out onto the ground here at the Adelaide Oval, and he's having a wonderful farewell. 55 for Border. Mark Waugh has won. 28 extras, 3 for 200.
Chant as he makes his way back to the dressing room. Pringle went very wide and dragged it back onto the off stump. Steve Waugh, the new batsman. 4 for 202. Australia needs 7 runs to win this match. Danny Morrison, right arm fast bowler, kind of fetal end. Pringle's bowled 10. Petrie and Watson also. And Pringle at third man, just the single. Both very relaxed batsmen in their stance, the Waugh brothers. Excellent balance. Both fine stroke players. Drive straight to cover. Four for 203. Drive, that's through. That almost go for four, the square boundary. Didn't quite get in the middle of the bat. I'll pick up 3 runs. Good running by Mark Waugh. Good consistent batting performance. Marsh 45, Boone 33, Jones 38, Border 55, 28 extras. 3 runs needed for victory. That It goes down to final. This will be the winning run. Swung down fine towards the boundary. It's racing towards the boundary, and that will be four. So a six-wicket win for Australia. Australia, four for 210. A convincing victory. Their second win of the series here at the Adelaide Oval.
That was an outstanding win by the Australians, led by Alan Border in the field and set up by the bowlers and fieldsmen and Border earlier in the day. The card at the end, 4 for 210 in reply to the New Zealanders, 7 for 208, and it took the Australians just 47 overs. Top score, Border 55, and a very, very good performance from him. Here's Ian Chappell now with the two skippers and the man of the match.
Thanks very much, Richie. Well, from the sponsorship funds from Benson Hedges, we have $1,500 for Martin Crowe, the losing captain. Martin, just not enough runs.
Not enough. Probably 25, 30 short.
Bit difficult for batting there?
Well, yeah, I certainly struggled, and I know the other guys did. The conditions, I think, helped a little bit with the overcast, but they bowled so well. So, you know, we didn't get enough.
All right, we'll see you in Perth.
Thanks a lot.
Alan Border, the winning captain, $3,000. Lads are playing pretty well.
Yes, I think we've started off very, very well. I can't complain about the effort that everyone's putting in. There's a couple of things I still would like to see improved. Too many no balls, for instance, today. But, you know, always looking for perfection.
You're a hard man to please, but this might put a smile on your face. The Benson Hedges people have got a crystal Baccarat ship's decanter, plus $500 for the man of the match. Well played.
Thanks very much. Yeah, as Martin said, the wicket was difficult to bat on. No one really sort of got in there and really took charge. It was one of those just odd days here in Adelaide where it was just a little bit too paced and a bit up and down. So that's why the scores were a little bit lower than maybe normal.
All right, keep up the good work.
Thanks, Sam.
Okay, back to you, Rich.
Thanks, Ian. Ian Chappell were the two skippers and the player of the match who happened to be the Australian captain as well. The points table in the World Series for 1990-91. Australia, from only two games, have 4 points and an outstanding run rate. New Zealand, 3 matches and 2 points, and England are pointless at this moment. Two big matches coming up at the weekend in Perth. They'll be very important in the competition and great entertainment as well. For the moment, it's good night from the Adelaide Oval. An outstanding win yesterday for New Zealand, and today Australia very much on top. For the moment, it's goodbye.